Good evening, and welcome to St. Jean Francis de Chantal. An especially warm welcome to those who may be visiting us today. Today is the 27th Sunday in Ordinary Time. This Mass is offered for John and Irene Petrikis, Verna M. D'Angelo, Edwin and Barbara Quapis, Clayton and Ella Harris, Joe Diga, Irene Kazinchak, Joanne M. Sipanik, and Anna Person. Please stand. Our opening hymn is number 742, The Church is One Foundation, number 742.
Thank you. where the abundance of your kindness surpassed the merits and desire of those who entreat you. Pour out your mercy upon us, to pardon what conscience dreads, and to give what prayer does not dare to ask. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you, in unity, Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. Let me now sing of my friend's song concerning his vineyard. My friend had a vineyard on a fertile hillside. He spaded it, cleared it of stones, and planted the choicest vines. Within it he built a watchtower and hewed out a wine press. Then he looked for the crop of grapes, but what it yielded was wild grapes. Now, inhabitants of Jerusalem and people of Judah, judge between me and my vineyard. What more was there to do for my vineyard that I had not done? Why, when I looked for the crop of grapes, did it bring forth wild grapes? Now I will let you know what I mean to do with my vineyard. Take away its hedge. Give it to grazing. Break through its wall. Let it be trampled. Yes, I will make it a ruin. It shall not be pruned or hoed, but overgrown with thorns and briars. I will command the clouds not to send rain upon it. The vineyard of the Lord of hosts is the house of Israel, and the people of Judah are his cherished plant. He looked for judgment, but see, bloodshed. For justice, but hark, the outcry. The word of the Lord.
Thank you.
of St. Paul to the Philippians. Brothers and sisters, have no anxiety at all, but in everything, by prayer and petition, with thanksgiving, make your requests known to God. Then the peace of God that surpasses all understanding will guard your hearts and minds in Christ Jesus. Finally, brothers and sisters, whatever is true, whatever is honorable, whatever is just, whatever is pure, whatever is lovely, whatever is gracious, if there is any excellence, and if there is anything worthy of praise, think about these things. Keep on doing what you have learned and received and heard and seen in me. Then the God of peace be with you. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
I think it's safe to say that how we act and how we treat each other, we learned when we were little children. And Robert Fulham wrote a trilogy of books. One in 1986, entitled, All I Really Need to Know I Learned in Kindergarten. It's true. Just think back to things we learned in kindergarten. Always take a nap. Share everything. Play fair. Don't hit people. Put things back where you found them. That's a big one. Clean up your own mess. Don't take things in our doors. Say you're sorry when you hurt somebody. Wash your hands before you eat. Live a balanced life. Learn some, think some. I said take a nap every afternoon. Be aware of one. I think that list covers most of what we learned as little ones. And we come, indeed, grow in wisdom and love, and hopefully those little things that we learn carry on into our adult life. As I would say, sometimes they don't. We also learned some other things when we were young. I am the Lord your God. You shall not have strange gods before me. Thou shalt not take the Lord's name in vain. Remember to keep the Lord's day holy. Honor thy mother and father. You shall not kill. You shall not commit adultery. You shall not bear false witness. Thou shalt not covet thy neighbor's wife. Thou shalt not covet thy neighbor's goods. We all learned those when we were little. Ten Commandments. A guide for us. Much like the things we learned in kindergarten when we were younger. Guides for us. Paul's letter to the Philippians is a very basic book. It's very simple. Last week we heard, honor your God and love your neighbor. Today we hear, do what is just, honorable, loving, kind. All things that are basic to being human. Basic to being human. Sometimes we get into a long dissertation when really it just boils down to those two commandments of the law. To love the Lord your God and to love your neighbor as yourself. As we celebrate this Eucharist, as we celebrate this day, may we give praise and thanks to God who reminds us once again that life is simple. Treat people how you want you to treat them. Be kind. Be loving. Lay off the horn in the trap. It's not going to move any quicker. We celebrate this Eucharist. God has blessed us in so many ways. We are called to indeed give praise and thanks to God. And St. Paul reminds the people, the Philippians, be ever thankful to God. Be ever thankful to God. We celebrate. May we be thankful and grateful for all that He has given to us. May we indeed share that gratefulness and love with each other. In one voice, we profess our one faith. I believe in one God,
Father Almighty, maker of heaven.
begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father, through whom all things were made, for us men and for our salvation, he came out of heaven. And by the Holy Spirit, was incarnate of the Virgin Mary, and became man. For our sake, he was so quiet and out of his heart, he suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through our hearts. I believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
You place our need in our petitions, and indeed our thanksgivings in the hands of loving Father.
That the evangelizing work of the church may bear fruit for the glory of God, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That all people may have their hearts open to the word of God spoken by his messengers, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That all who suffer from anxiety may find comfort and peace in Jesus, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That all of us gathered here may be strengthened by our communion in Christ, the true vine, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That all who have died may be at peace in God's heavenly kingdom, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
With thanksgiving for your many blessings, we bring to the altar the intentions of this Mass, those in our prayer box and website, and those in our hearts. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Gracious, loving God, you know our hearts and our prayers long before your voice. In your love and in your mercy, may they be granted through you, we ask all of this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Our offertory hymn is number 578, How Great Thou Art, number 578.
may my friends, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and for the cause of his holy church.
Accept, O Lord, we pray, the sacrifices instituted by your commands, and that through the sacred mysteries, which we celebrate with dutiful service, graciously complete the sanctifying work by which you are pleased to redeem us through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your heart.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty, eternal God. For you laid the foundation of the world, you reign with the changing times and seasons. You form us in your own image, setting us over the whole world and all its wonder. And so with all the angels, we praise you in joyful celebration. We pray.
Forever and ever.
at the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil, grace, and grant peace in our day, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin, safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Lord Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not at our sin, but the faith of your church. In grace, he grant your peace and unity in accordance with your will, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And your spirit.
Let us offer to each other a sign of peace.
Thank you.
Bring forth the kingdom. Number 734.